Schizophedra. And then we're going to transition over to John McDougall and a recent interview he did with a good friend of mine, Chef AJ. So I want you to stay tuned because this is going to be a jam-packed, fun session. Let's start right away with going right to Arnold.
Amend. The former California governor shared an important health update on Friday, giving fans a thumbs up from his hospital bed after undergoing heart surgery in Cleveland. Arnold revealed on Instagram that everything went smoothly, and his prognosis is so good, in fact, he's even enjoying some sightseeing on his early road to recovery, writing, "Thanks to the team at the Cleveland Clinic, I have a new aortic valve to go along with my new pulmonary valve from my last surgery. I feel fantastic and have already been walking the streets of Cleveland enjoying your amazing statues. Thank you to every doc and nurse on my team." Arnold's latest operation was his second cardiac procedure in 2 years, and it's great to see him in such good spirits so shortly after going under the knife. The action superstar's kids joined thousands of followers offering well wishes in the comments section of his post, with new mom Katherine Schwarzenegger posting a string of heart and praying hands emojis, and her brother Patrick advising their famously fit dad to take it easy, writing, "Please don't go work out today." We're betting that piece of advice got a chuckle out of Arnold. The 73-year-old's sense of humor is another one of his greatest strengths. Case in point, we're still not over this epic fake-out Arnold posted back in May, fooling at least some fans into thinking he could do the splits.
Flexibility is just as important as weight training itself. So here we go. Suck it in, up with your arms, and then bend slowly to the side.
Notice Arnold is smoking a cigar. Not real good for the heart, guys.
Anyway, I feel very flexible today. I'm really proud of myself.
That's funny. That's really funny. Yeah, you got to hand it to Arnold. He's such a sharp entrepreneur, former governor, movie star. He's got it all. I just want to mention to you that he's gone mostly plant-based. I'm hoping that he goes that next step to 100% plant-based, because really, whether it be the aortic valve or the use of surgery intervention, Cleveland Clinic, arguably one of the great centers in the world, but also Caldwell Esselstyn, who wrote his book, Prevent and Reverse Heart Disease, practices at Cleveland Clinic, and it turns out that Caldwell Esselstyn, one of his colleagues who is a heart surgeon, had to face the reality that he might need bypass surgery. And instead, Caldwell Esselstyn trained him about oil-free, sugar-free, whole plant-based foods. And essentially, he was one of the early cases that in his book that he reported showing before after angiograms of complete reversal of cardiovascular disease, the clogged arteries to his heart. So this is a life-saving procedure, and it's so important to know about it, and so few people have recognized yet the great importance. As I learned 43 years ago after having suffered a TIA, transient ischemic attack, you know, I wasn't always healthy. So, you know, for me to have lost that weight and increased my circulation and kind of get to that place where, you know, life is so critical to us. But let's jump into the next subject here, optimizing water intake to lose weight. Here we go.
Drink 2 cups of water and you get a surge of the adrenal hormone noradrenaline in your bloodstream, as if you just smoked a few cigarettes or downed a few cups of coffee, which boosts your metabolic rate up to 30% within an hour, which, when put to the test, in randomized controlled trials, appear to accelerate weight loss by 44%, certainly making it the safest, simplest, and cheapest way to boost your metabolism. Now, if you're on a beta blocker drug, this entire strategy may fail. Beta blockers are typically prescribed for heart conditions or high blood pressure and tend to end with the letters LOL, such as atenolol, natolol, or propranolol, sold us to Norman Korgard or Inderol, respectively. So, for example, if you give people the beta blocker drug metoprolol, sold as Lopressor, before they chug their two cups of water, the metabolic boost is effectively prevented. And this makes sense since the beta that's being blocked in beta blockers are the beta receptors triggered by noradrenaline. Otherwise, though, the water should work, but what's the best kind of dose type, temperature, and timing? Just a single cup may be sufficient to rev up the noradrenaline nerves, but additional benefit is seen at two or more cups. Caution, one should never drink more than three cups in an hour, though, since that starts to exceed the amount of fluid your kidneys can handle.
Okay, so really good advice. Two cups of water within about 30 minutes of a meal or so, and particularly that's because it's going to help to reduce the appetite and help accelerate metabolic rates to burn more calories. As good as some of other procedures or even avoiding food, we really don't want you to avoid food. We want you to get used to eating whole natural foods. So let's keep in mind this is a great breakthrough. Here, let me take us back to the next part to continue this discussion with our reply to optimizing water intake to lose weight with Michael Greger.
If you have heart or kidney failure, your physician may not want you drinking extra water at all, but even with healthy kidneys, any more than three cups of water an hour can start to critically dilute the electrolytes in your brain with potentially critical consequences. In How Not to Diet, I talk about the first patient I ever killed in the hospital as an intern. I was a guy who drunk himself to death with water. He suffered from a neurological condition that causes pathological thirst. I knew enough to order his liquids be restricted and to have his sink shut off, but didn't think to turn off his toilet. Anyways.
Wow. That's pretty concerning that some people will literally drink themselves to death and... So don't overdo the fluids. But, you know, the common recommendation is 8 glasses of water a day. I like to get a lot of my water from whole fruits and vegetables. And so let's continue with this informative section here.
Does it have to be plain, straight water? It shouldn't seem to matter, right? I mean, water is water, whether flavored or sweetened in some diet drink. But it does matter. When trying to prevent fainting before blood donation, something like juice doesn't work as well as plain water. When trying to keep people from getting dizzy when they stand up, water works, but the same amount of water with salt added doesn't. What's going on? We used to think the trigger was stomach distension. When we eat, our body shifts blood flow to our digestive tract, in part by releasing noradrenaline to pull in blood from our limbs. This has been called the gastrovascular reflex. So drinking water was thought to be just a zero-calorie way of stretching our stomach. But instead, drink two cups of saline, basically salt water, and the metabolic boost vanishes. So stomach expansion can't explain the water effect. We now realize our body appears to detect osmolarity, the concentration of stuff within a liquid. Covertly slip liquids of different concentrations into people's stomachs with a feeding tube, and you can demonstrate this by monitoring sweat production, which is kind of a proxy for noradrenaline release. This may be a spinal reflex, as it's preserved in quadriplegics, or picked up by the liver, as we see less noradrenaline release in liver transplant patients who've had their liver nerves severed. Whichever the pathway, our body can tell. Thought we only had 5 senses? The current count is upwards of 33, so maybe the Bruce Willis movie should have been called the 34th sense. In my daily dozen recommendation,
So that's really informative to understand the power of drinking water during the course of the day. And again, 2 glasses of water is great. There was a question about adrenal effect, and the adrenals play a huge role in our overall health. One of the things I like to encourage people to recognize is adrenal health is influenced by adrenal herbs, ashwagandha, the use of the adrenal glandular. These are tremendously important in conjunction with a whole foods diet. And of course, it goes without saying, when you exercise, ideally do it outdoors in the sun, because the sun stimulates the adrenal response and improves adrenal function. And a particular Marine there, Chaos, mentioned the idea that the Marines, that they drink a lot of extra water. Of course, they were perspiring a lot, and that makes sense too. I personally like to take in cold press juices to make sure that I'm getting sufficient fluids in addition to the water. But let's see, overall concept is
teas is among the healthiest beverages. After all, they have all the water of water with an antioxidant bonus. But from a weight loss perspective, plain water may have an edge. That may explain the study showing overweight and obese individuals randomized to replace diet beverages with water lost significantly more weight. This was chalked up to getting rid of all those artificial sweeteners. But maybe instead the diet drinks were too concentrated to offer the same water-induced metabolic boost. Diet soda, tea, has about 10 times the concentration of dissolved substances compared to tap water. So plain water on an empty stomach may be the best. Does the temperature of the water matter? In a journal published by the American Society of Mechanical Engineers, an engineering professor proposed that the secret of a raw food diet for weight loss was the temperature at which the food was served. To bring 2 cups of even just room temperature water up to body temperature, he calculated, the body would have to dip into its fat stores and use up 6,000 calories. So look, just do the math, right? He says a calorie is defined as the amount of energy required to raise 1 gram of water 1 degree Celsius. So since 2 cups of water is about 500 grams, and the difference between room temp and body temp is about 12 degrees Celsius, 500 times 12 equals 6,000 plus calories needed. Anyone see the mistake? In nutrition, a calorie is actually a kilocalorie, 1,000 times bigger than the same word used in the rest of the sciences. Confusing, right? Still, I'm shocked the paper was even published. So, drinking 2 cups of room temperature water actually only takes 6 calories to warm up, not 6,000. Now, if you were a hummingbird drinking 4 times your body weight in chili nectar, you could burn up to 2% of your energy reserves warming it up, but it doesn't make as much of a difference for us. What about really cold water, though? A letter called the Ice Diet was published in the Annals of Internal Medicine, estimated that eating about a quart of ice, like a really, really big snow cone with no syrup, could rob our body of more than 150 calories, the same amount of energy as the calorie expenditure in running 1 mile. It's not like you directly burn fat to warm up the water, though. I mean, what your body does is just corrals more of the waste heat you normally give off by constricting blood flow to your skin. How does it do that? Noradrenaline. If you compare drinking body temperature water to room temperature water, to cold water, there's only a significant constriction in blood flow to the skin after the room temp and cold water. And neither the warm or tepid water could boost metabolic rate as much as cold fridge temperature water. So your body does, after all, end up at least indirectly burning off more calories when you drink your water cold. So 2 cups of cold water on an empty stomach a few times a day. Does it matter when? Yes. Watch my evidence-based weight loss lecture to see how you can add the benefit.
Okay, so 2 cups of water on a essentially empty stomach, and that is the best way to drop extra calories. Now, it didn't matter if it was cold per se, but it did make a difference. The colder the water, it seemed to make a difference. Now, I hear of many health experts talking about using water at room temperature, but again, it depends on the outcome you want. And many people are struggling to drop body fat. And one of the great tips is to go ahead and drink extra water. Now, remember, the concentration he mentioned, it can't just be any fluid. If it's a soda pop, it has a lot of concentration, whether it be of sugar and other molecules in there, whereas just plain, still, purified water. I don't take it straight from the tap, of course. I take it from a multi-pure. It goes through a carbon filter, and then it goes through living water or echo device to concentrate the molecular hydrogen, and then I drink the water. And I wanted to show you just briefly, too, the importance of this overall concept in improving your circulation. In the center here is a white blood cell, and these are red blood cells around the side. The reason they're a little spiky type is they've been sitting there for about 3 hours since I pricked a finger from my own blood. And, you know, the whole idea was that our circulation, our blood cells flow in plasma. So the terrain, the background, is critical to good health. And we know that maintaining hydration, not just for weight loss, but for reducing the incidence of cancer, for improving our blood pressure, for exercise, all of these things, water is absolutely critical. Again, I like the nutrient density, and I'm at a good body weight, so I use cold-pressed vegetable juices. I don't juice my fruit. I eat my fruit because it's rich in water, and I juice my vegetables, or I buy it cold-pressed that same day, and that makes it extremely efficient for me. So your blood cells, your white blood cells, your immune system, all of these factors play a huge role in overall good health. So I wanted to bring you to the concept that health and longevity. One of my good friends here, I wanted to bring up John McDougall in his recent interview with Chef AJ, and I'm looking to get John on my show. He was on my show about a year ago, so here we go.
I would like to be able to give you happy news. I'd like to tell you that the virus is going to go away, like some people are telling you. It's not going to go away. It's going to become endemic. I'd like to be able to tell you that there's a vaccine that's going to be highly effective, inexpensive, and perfectly safe. But I can't tell you that. But I can tell you, I can tell you something very important. Is number one is you have a tool that you learned via television, other kinds of media that really works, and you should pay attention to it. And that tool has to do with public health methods. You know, wearing a mask, washing your hands, keeping a fair distance from people, whether that be 6, 12, or 20 feet, probably more like 20 feet. And, you know, just protecting yourself. So you have that tool that everybody else in the world has.
So, you know, the one area I find important for people to recognize is don't become germ-phobic. Certainly the common recommendations, but the best of them is essentially washing your hands. So washing your hands is a good idea. Again, covering up your face, facial recognition, I have my opinions about that. You really need to watch the documentary by model health gentleman. It's really good, Stevenson, and I think you'll find that very, very informative. But really, let's jump into what his comments are about the diet.
Climate, COVID comet. Because if we as a, I got it. Okay, as we as a population, if we, you know, China, Russia, Thailand, Somalia, I mean, people from all over the world, if we saw a comet heading towards us and would be here in 6 months and destroy our planet, we'd do everything we could to build missiles, to do whatever, space flights, anything to save our planet. Because we can see the emergency. Well, I look at COVID as that comet to tell us what's in store for us very shortly as far as climate change occurs. And we're not, by the time we come to the same realization we have with COVID-19, in other words, we've had to shut down society, we've had to stop all of our airplane flying and all our transportation, we've cut down on fossil fuels. We've done that with COVID-19. It's made us aware that we can change. If we would go to that point with climate change, we're already covering Florida with 20 feet of water. It's too late. So anyway, the thing I'm giving this presentation on Thursday night, October 22nd, to a 500.
Dr. McDougall,
American College of Lifestyle Medicine, which are physicians,
oh, so
scientists.
Got it.
There'll probably be 3,500 people listening.
Wow, that would be.
So it's exciting because, you know, we're in an age of awareness, and I do have a comment about, you know, of course, as author of Blood Doesn't Lie, I'm proud to share this information with you. It was mentioned about does water somehow, it took away appetite. You know, we keep in mind, we're 80% water as humans. we have this terrain, the circulation, the lymph, the muscles. Every part of our body requires water to function. So maintain your hydration. And guess what? The biggest dehydrator of all, can you imagine? It's attempting to digest animal protein, meat, cheese, eggs, and dairy product, and fats. These foods are going to make you chronically dehydrated. And the reason I know that is when you read the book, Our Body's Many Cries for Water by Dr. Bat Majlin, he explains how when you're dehydrated, the urine runs yellow. It's darker yellow when you eat even more animal protein. But when you go to plant proteins, it's easier to digest. And just think about it. Fruit has water in it. Vegetables has water in it. So you're getting hydrated and you're not depleting your body of water. So water and hydration is one of the critical factors in remaining healthy. So in my book, Blood Doesn't Lie, I give you the 35 steps that can profoundly improve your health, your immune system, your circulation. And I summarize them in 5 simple steps. So please check that out. It's on Amazon now. And do check out our coaching eligibility. So this is Dr. Nick Delgado. It's been exciting. Thank you so much. We'll see you at the next show, everyone. It's really, really, really important that we get these get-togethers and share with you the latest advice. And my next section, I'm going to talk about high-level physical fitness and performance. So thanks, everyone. Be well, be strong, at your ideal body weight, and loving life.